Tonight on My News, agreement in Poland. World leaders decide on a rule book on how to curb climate change, but does it go far enough? We can halve the number of road deaths and serious injuries. That's the government pledge as it announces more than $1 billion to fix up our most dangerous stretches of road. And hoping for a love affair, two takahe are flown to a new home with hopes they'll become a breeding pair. Good evening. After delays, arguments and years of talks, the world's leaders have now agreed on how to limit climate change. The decision was announced to wide applause earlier today at the COP24 climate conference in Poland. Nearly 200 countries thrashed out a 156-page rulebook which aims to deliver the goals of the Paris Agreement from 3 years ago. That is, to limit a rise in average world temperatures to well below 2 degrees above pre-industrial levels. The rulebook says how countries will report and monitor their greenhouse emissions. For more on the decision, the BBC's science editor David Shookman reports. Now, still to come here on One News, criticism over Australia's controversial announcement on Israel's capital. Could it be putting its own people at risk? Untouched and unlooted, archaeologists celebrate the discovery of a 4,000-year-old tomb in near-perfect condition. So what secrets will it reveal from the 5th dynasty? And talk about pressure, the arranged marriage that has the survival of a species resting on its romance. Here's hoping Fife and Mulgrew hit it off.
Sunday's here.
Merry Kirimiti Aotearoa.
Tonight on One.
Australia has been warned it could be endangering its own citizens after announcing it's accepted West Jerusalem as Israel's capital. It's just the fourth country in the world to do so. Israel's response has been tepid, while Palestinians have condemned the decision and urged caution.
The bottom line is that it could spark violence here in Australia.
Yes, this is a very sensitive issue, and because of that, it could.
Australia says it won't move its embassy from Tel Aviv, though, until a peace settlement is achieved. And staying in Australia, a freak storm left much of Melbourne underwater this weekend, with flash flooding leaving some motorists stranded on top of their cars. Nine News correspondent Sam Cucciara reports.
Relic with a chance at a future, too. Jenny Saw, One News.
Now, just ahead on My News, how ice crystals at Antarctica are helping scientists better understand climate change. And a tip on how to ensure you don't come out of the festive season looking like Santa.
And it's a fine start to the working week for most of us. However, wet and windy weather arrives on Tuesday, working us over from the south. What to expect and the day's temperatures for you after sport.
Get to TVNZ On Demand. It's yours.
Our top stories tonight here on One News. A $1.4 billion road improvement program has been launched to help make our roads safer. The government's hoping the improvements to our most dangerous routes will help save 160 deaths and serious injuries each year. Greenpeace is criticising the set of rules agreed to by world leaders in relation to limiting the planet's rising temperatures. The deal was announced in Poland a few hours ago, a 156-page rulebook which aims to deliver the goals of the Paris Agreement. But Greenpeace says it goes nowhere near far enough to avoid the impacts of a warming planet. As the world's leaders decide how to stop the world's temperatures from rising, scientists are studying changes in Antarctic ice to help them better understand climate change. There's been an increase in sea ice around the continent, but there's concern that's only because of a gradual melt of the ice shelf. Lisa Davies has more.
Christmas past may come back to haunt you. Kate King, One News.
Right, Jenny May's got all that, so have I. Jenny May's here. The Black Caps well in control of day two of the cricket test.
Here we are for the very last time. Pete, here's Kane Williamson and Tom Latham. Absolutely brilliant with the bat this afternoon, both notching up half centuries at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. Latham, though, going on to claim his seventh test century.
That one there. No, he can't beat mid-off. He'll have to run two. He goes to 99. Well, you know, he'll pick it up on an overthrow.
And low blow Joe, Kiwi heavyweight boxer Joseph Parker sheds the nice guy tag for a controversial knockout win. And fresh off winning team of the year at the New Zealand Rugby Awards, Seven Sisters captain Sarah Goss claims more silverware. Just before I go, Pete, on your final night, I would just like to say on behalf of the sports team, it's been an honour and a privilege. And for me personally, it has... Keep it together, Jenny May. Thank you for your friendship and thank you for your guidance as well. And I have, although I'm very, very sad, I have some wonderful memories of us working together. So thank you, Pete, and I wish you well.
Kia ora. Jenny May, thank you. Renee is here with the weather next.
Kia ora. Tonight on One, the two-part doco Queen of the World concludes, followed by the raucous comedy special Michael McIntyre, Happy and Glorious. On two, Vince Vaughn gets festive in Fred Claus. Then there's family dysfunction in Little Fockers. And on Duke, there's live squash from the New Zealand Invitational featuring Kiwi stars Paul Cole and Joelle King. Plus, the tense wartime drama Das Boot is on demand now.
Whatever the weather, gear up, go camping with Torpedo 7.
Kia ora, welcome back. It's been a very enjoyable, settled Sunday across Aotearoa under a strong ridge of high wet and windy conditions to the south from Tuesday. That is your weather. Pete, last time we're going to do this. I'm going to miss you. You've been my bud and it's been an absolute pleasure to work with you. So thank you.
Thank
now
you
look
too,
who's
mate.
Here, Wendy and Simon. And
yes, indeed.
With a very special little surprise for a very special man.
That's right, Renee. Thanks. There is no good sorts tonight, but we are farewelling and paying tribute to a real good sort of our own. Now, you may recognise this fresh-faced young fella here. Yes, he was a little bit younger then. Yes, he had a little bit more hair, but you've got to admit he is smooth
that one.
And still is
that
smooth.
That shot in particular.
That's exactly right. And after nearly 40 years in the TV game, 39 years, 8 months to be exact, Peter is leaving TVNZ.
Yes, indeed. He's covered 7 Olympics, numerous Commonwealth Games, rugby and cricket World Cups, and of course, being a keen golfer, a couple of Masters tournaments too, you lucky bugger. And from breakfast to One News at 6, to Mastermind and numerous other broadcasting roles, Pete's been a constant presence on our screen, literally, for decades.
From all the One News family, I'd like to say, and I'm sure the viewers would like to say, all the best to you, Pete. We absolutely adore you. We're going to miss you so much. And last words,
Ki. Kia waimarie, haurera. Thanks for the memories, Pete.
And thank you guys for your collegiality over the years and for your friendship as well.
Just a minute, we've just got a little few clips.
Have a look at this.
The sporting 70s were a 10-year period different from any other in the history of sport. Yet not because the only of the players who won in Canada,
including two matches.
The sweet, sweet, sweet memories you gave of me, you can't beat. The memories you gave
me. Climax Sport 81 with the announcement of the JVC Sports Personality of the Year. The winner to receive this JVC colour television set. Glenn Turner, you were with me in the commentary box that day in Auckland. Do you remember it as a fairly unique kind of cricketing occasion as far as New Zealand's concerned?
Well, it's not unique in the fact that we won.
For the average club golfer, it can be the most infuriating game of all. The object being to hit a small ball any distance up to 600 yards with a funny shaped thing called a golf club into a small hole just 4.5 inches in diameter.
Peter, I guess the All Black selectors couldn't really have asked for much better than what they got down there today.
Indeed, Brendan, as far as the atmosphere alone was concerned, we had sunshine, lovely ground, big crowd and two very fine games of rugby.
This means 4, this means 6, this means you're out. But here on Saturday there could be a new umpire signal used for the first time in New Zealand, and it goes like this.
The first step towards World Cup glory. Peter Williams, One Network News.
As they say, good health.
Good health. Good health.
And after 100 years, the Olympic movement is as strong as ever. That concludes our coverage. Thank you for bearing with us. The
These are the dreams you will say.
As time goes by, I think that we'll see farewell services, individual services for the 29 victims.
Yes, four contenders tonight who all think they have what it takes to be New Zealand's mastermind.
It generously
Jonah, it is a very happy occasion for the Sevens fans in Fiji.
Thank you for joining us for this One News special on the aftermath of the major 7.5 earthquake.
Yeah, I do know what's going to happen tonight, but I'm not going to tell you because that would spoil the surprise.
There's enough possibilities here to make the way of our future a much smoother ride. Peter Williams, One Network News.
I don't remember many of those incidents. So, yes, this is my last broadcast here on TV One. I first appeared on this network, in fact, in July of 1979 as a rugby league commentator, and I wasn't a very good one either. Over the years, I've had a few jobs here, reported a few stories, seen a bit of the world and enjoyed, well, pretty much all of it. But everything must finish. So to my colleagues over the decades, thank you for your talent and your hard work and support. But most importantly, to you, our audience, thank you for your extraordinary loyalty, which makes this the most watched program on New Zealand television every day. Maybe we'll meet again someday. From One News, good night.
I've got to bring you out some flowers.
Got those flowers for you.
And the flowers.
There's a few
people
who
want to say that. You've been extraordinary, Peter.
A lady for next year.
Hey. Keep talking.
You're right. Hey, keep talking.
Any more words, Peter?
Thank you so much, everybody.
Mm-hmm.